CKVR does it all summer long with Leave It to Beaver, weekdays at noon.
Hello there, you all. This is the old lawman, Deputy Dawg. I wear the legal star on my chest, and I'm the legal star of this cotton-picking show. Me and my natural-born buddies, Muskrat, Vincent Van Gopher, and Tycoon, are all set to bring you a passel of rib-tickling and hair-raising adventures. So you all get comfortable out there, because here we go!
Dadnabbit! Mow the grass, paint the jail, mop the floor, and in between time catch criminals. Hey! Oops! I didn't see you coming around the corner there, Sheriff.
Why, I think nothing of it, boy. I can get new pants and boots for about 2 weeks of your salary. Now, here's an eviction notice for that scientist, Dr. Molecule. He hasn't paid his rent, and the owner wants him evicted. Immediately!
Work, work, work! I'd quit this cotton-picking job if I wasn't afraid of getting fired.
Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Wrong one again. Interruptions, always interruptions. Why do they always happen when I'm doing something? Come in, please, before you make me cuckoo.
I'm not coming in. You're going out for not paying the rent, boy.
The science is more important than the rent.
Dagnabbit!
Ludwig! Ludwig!
At your service, Professor. Coming on the double.
Now, just a doggone minute. You're resisting an officer of the law. You're under arrest, you cotton-picking bucket of nuts and bolts. It's a good thing this rock was here, or I could have been hurt.
Good, Ludwig.
I'm your boy, Professor. Anything you say goes.
Freeze, Dr. Molecule. Now, do you come along peaceful-like, or do I turn this robot into a tin sieve?
Now, I say, Norman, don't you know it's impolite to point... Why don't you just mosey down the road and check the traffic situation, copper?
Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Maybe this time I get lucky.
Gotcha this time, Molecule. You didn't pay the rent, so out you go. That first step was a real skull-denter.
Oh, Ludwig, our friend the pest is back.
I'm going! Once I get rid of that robot, that scientist chap will be easy. And this booby trap magnet ought to do it. The party's over, Dr. Molecule. I'm gonna dynamite that tin toy of yours right back to the junkyard.
Oh, no. Please don't hurt my Ludwig. He's innocent. He only obeys the orders. No, don't hurt my Ludwig. Don't hurt my Ludwig. You did a real good job evicting that scientist, Deputy Dawg. I'm sure glad we're rid of that little freeloader. Oops. Well, wrong again.
Why, you melonhead? Don't tell me you're giving him free rent in the jail. Well, not exactly free, Sheriff. It's being worked for. You see?
Paint the jail, keep the grass cut, mop the floors, wash the sheriff's car. wonder what I look like. Some sort of a machine.
Share a little bit of yourself without even knowing. When you share a little bit of yourself, you'll find good feelings growing. When
you share the best of you, someone else is better too.
When you share the best of you, you'll find good feelings growing.
When you get a glow that feels someone inside
better too.
You share yourself and your heart opens wide.
When you share a little bit of yourself without even knowing. When you share a little bit of yourself, you'll find good feelings growing.
No one else can. Yourself. From the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, the Mormons.
CKVR does it all summer long with Silver Spoons, Friday at 6.
Oh, close that door, Davy. You're letting in hot air.
Mom, that settles it. I'm going to get you an air conditioner.
An air conditioner for an open car?
I just can't let you suffer in this heat.
Barb will be furious. She's been wanting an air conditioner for the living room.
Mom, I got a big deal coming up. If it goes through, I'll be able to get them both. I want to get yours first. No offense, but you're older.
How is an air conditioner in the car going to make me more comfortable?
Well, that's simple. I'm going to point the vents inside to cool the motor off.
Point it inside to cool the motor off. I don't get it, Dave. You treat this car like it was
human.
My wife doesn't get a physical as often as this car.
Well, your wife's not a 1928 Porter, Doc. Won't you pick it up for me?
Boy, oh boy.
It'll cost you $325.48.
That high, huh?
Well, for $2.30, you can buy a new fan belt. That'll cool your motor off.
Not this summer, Doc. It's going to be a scorcher. Well, I'll let you know.
Dave, the cooling vents pointed...
Enough already, Doc. Enough?
$325.48? That's pretty high, Davy.
I know. But I'm just about to land a new plan and a big fat retainer. Besides, I can't let you go all summer without air conditioning.
What's Barbara going to say?
Don't worry about Barbara, Mom. A little butter up and she'll melt. I mean, what does a wife want most anyway? A kind word, a warm hug, and a juicy kiss. The big three.
It's called the big three. A kind word, a warm hug, and a juicy kiss. Treat your father like that and we'll have no problem. Okay, now let's try it again, but give it everything you've got. Remember, it's going to be a hot summer and we need an air conditioner here in the living room. Now, pretend I'm Daddy. And I've just come in. Bob, honey, I'm home.
Daddy, hold it. What are you kids trying to do with the Academy Award? What is this Daddykin? You sound like Shirley Temple.
Who's Shirley Temple?
I just dated myself.
Why do we have to go through all this? Why don't we just say to Daddy we want an air conditioner?
How long have you kids been with this organization? Remember when you wanted Daddy to buy you a new skateboard? What did you do?
We buttered him up.
I rest my case. There he is. Battle stations, everybody.
Oh, I forgot to turn the thermostat up to hot.
There, that should help with the air conditioning.
Everybody knows in the second life we all come back sooner or later. As anything from a pussycat to a man-eating alligator. Well, you all may think my story is more fiction than it's fact. But believe it or not, my mother did decided she'd come back as a car. She's a very own guiding star. A 1928 Porter, that my mother did. She helped me through everything I do, and I'm so glad she's here. My mother, the car.
brother McCall.
Clear of my hub! Paul, Sadlin that is, wants to clear over 170 used cars and trucks before the new models arrive. He's downright serious about this clear out. Paul's setting up the bar goonies, so if you're looking for a sports car, a truck, a station wagon, a van, or a luxury car, now's the time. During Paul Sadlin's used car clear out!
Paul Sadlin Motors, Chevrolet, Oldsmobile, Cadillac, 550 Bayfield Street, Barrie.
Spend the summer with CKVR. Wednesday night at 6, join the crew of the Starship Enterprise on Star Trek.
Get those men aboard fast.
Right away, Captain.
Then it's square pegs at 7.
I'm trying to listen. Eavesdropping is almost as good as being talked to.
Followed by Three's a Crowd at 7:30. We're doing it for you all summer long on CKVR. Spend the summer with CKVR. Weekday mornings at 11, be sure to watch the zaniest redhead of all time.
Now you shut up!
On I Love Lucy. Next, it's more classic comedy on My Three Sons at 11:30.
You're a real Arnold Bennett.
And then at noon, drop in at the Cleaver household for Leave It to Beaver.
Larry, just get off.
We're doing it for you all summer long on CKVR.
Barb's, honey, I'm home.
Daddy, dear. Let me take your shoes off. My daddy's here.
I don't want my shoes off.
If I don't take your shoes off, how am I supposed to get your slippers on?
Well, never mind my slippers. All right, I'll put on my slippers.
Have some hot chocolate.
Hot chocolate? Where's the cold lemonade? It's warm in here.
I know. Isn't it awful? And the summer's barely begun. I'm so sorry you're warm, dear.
Wait a minute. I don't...
Relax now. You've had a hard day at a cool office.
And driving on the freeway in a hot car.
Bart! Honey, what are you doing standing up? Here, I'll let you sit down. That's it. Read the paper.
Oh, no. You read the paper.
No, why don't... Bart?
Yes?
Why is everybody being so considerate all of a sudden? You want something.
Oh, don't be silly. What could we possibly want that we don't have already?
An air conditioner.
Well, that let the cat out of the bag.
How did you know? Did Doc Benson call?
Doc Benson? What's he got to do with this?
Oh, he gave me a great deal. Only $325.48.
What's only $325.48?
The air conditioner.
Dave, darling! Oh! Oh, it's going to be so nice and cool.
Thank you, honey.
Oh, don't thank me, Dave. We thank you.
Oh, no, we thank you.
We?
Yeah, the porter and I.
The porter?
It's going to be such a hot summer. What a comfort to have air conditioning in the car.
In the car? It's an open car.
Of course it's an open car. That's why it's so important to have air conditioning. All that hot sun gets in there. Look at the frozen food section at the supermarket. That's open.
We had hope. A wild, ridiculous hope that the air conditioner was for the living room.
Air conditioner for the living room? Barb, you don't understand.
As Kosigan said to Dean Rusk, don't touch me.
You're not listening. Order the air conditioner.
Darling!
Now that we all understand each other, how about getting rid of that hot chocolate and please turn off the heat?
You knew?
I knew. And if I don't land this deal tomorrow, nobody gets an air conditioner. It's a new client.
You'll close it, honey.
Yeah, but what if I don't?
We'll love you no matter what.
Boy, if I could just figure the right approach, I could land that client in a minute.
Be aggressive, Dave. Decisive.
That's my whole trouble. I don't aggress when I shouldn't, and I decise when I shouldn't.
Who is this man, honey?
Franklin Hotchkiss. Married 8 times, divorced 8 times, a perennial party thrower.
Old party pants Hotchkiss.
Well, I'm having lunch with him, and he's accountable.
Well, there's only one way to handle him.
I know. Be aggressive, decisive.
Yes. Also be a backslapper, joke teller, round of drinks orderer, and a tab picker-upper. be all of that, and you'll get Hotchkiss. And Barbara and I will get the air conditioners.
No, I can be all that. At least I can try.
Hello there, folksies. Make way for the big stir, baby, because it's Crabtree a go-go time.